So imagine if someone could take your voice and make you say whatever they wanted. It's not only possible, it's actually simple, thanks to artificial intelligence. Voice cloning is becoming one of the most common scams. CBS4's Max Lewis shows us how it works and how you can protect yourself.
It's never been easier to create artificial content, right? You can do it with a few keystrokes. You can create an image, you can create a video, you can create an audio file, and anybody can do it.
Scammers are using artificial intelligence to do what's called voice cloning. Scott Shackelford is the director of IU's Center for Applied Cybersecurity Research and showed us how it works.
This is a free website that anybody can sign up for. It's called PlayHT.
After creating a simple account, Shackelford uploaded a video of a recent lecture he gave and then typed in the message he wanted the computer to say using his voice.
Sorry it's late on a Friday, but time is short. Can you do a quick wire transfer before heading out for the day? Here's the details.
You didn't say any of those words.
Didn't say any of those words in the talk. Didn't talk anything about this.
According to the Federal Trade Commission, consumers lost nearly $3 billion from impersonation scams, and artificial intelligence has made it easier and more convincing than ever before.
People just aren't used to that yet, right? We're used to getting robocalls all the time, but to actually get a phone call and it sounds like you're talking to your grandson or your parent even, and they're in some tough situation and it's cut off suddenly, That's disturbing, right?
Data from the FTC shows that adults over 60 are 45% more likely to fall for these types of scams.
But we wanted to see how easily it could be done to younger people. So with her mother's permission, I tried it out on my 13-year-old niece.
Like most teenagers, Amara spends a lot of time on her phone and social media. My sister, her mom, says navigating this brave new world can be frightening. Like in a game of chess, one wrong move can have consequences.
Kids being susceptible to anything is scary. And then you add in this component that is able to emulate or mirror something that is familiar, you know, because we teach, you know, don't get in the car with strangers. Well, now that's kind of out the window now. It's, you know, is it a stranger? Is this real?
Using the same website as Shackelford, I uploaded a clip of me from a newscast and then typed a message just asking for my niece's address. I was able to adjust how fast or slow I spoke or even what emotion I used. I then sent her the audio via text from an unrecognized number.
Hey, Amara, it's Uncle Max. My phone died, so I'm using my work phone. Can you send me your address? I want to send your mom something, but want it to be a surprise. Thanks.
There was like a little second, like, when he was like, hi, Amara. I was like, that's Max's voice. I can identify it. But then I was like, wait, that's just like super off.
She was almost immediately suspicious and took it straight to her mom.
I didn't listen closely. I just, you know, she put on speaker and I was like, yeah, that's Max. That sounds just like Max. I was surprised that she kind of thought anything else of it.
Her suspicion was a relief. Like most people her age, AI is not a foreign concept.
I do think their like affinity for technology makes them a little bit more aware of like the potential for AI. I think probably more than we would initially think. I think it's easy to assume they're vulnerable.
Even though she didn't fall for it, the fact that she didn't swear it off outright demonstrates how convincing the technology can be. And because so much of who we are is accessible online, Shackelford says it's never been easier to pretend to be someone else.
You don't need any specialty training, you know, in cybersecurity for sure, or coding or anything of the kind. If you can download an app, you can do this too.
The Federal Trade Commission is considering a rule change that would ban impersonating someone else, and some states even have laws on the books that protect your biometric information. Indiana is not one of them. Best way to protect yourself, according to experts, is just to be vigilant and make sure to check with your family members, friends, or possibly even coworkers to make sure it's actually them before you do anything. In the newsroom, Max Lewis, CBS 4 News.
Max.